off, Jason.
Hell yeah!
Hey, what's up, guys? Nick the Informative Fisherman here on behalf of Lucky Tackle Box, and today we're going to be breaking down the Spooltech 4-Inch Fatty Pro Series. Let's get it started. Now, a lot of people ask, you know, when do you fish a little swim bait like this? And the beauty of little soft swim baits is you can fish them year-round. Spring through winter, back into spring again, sunny, clear, murky, overcast, windy. You can catch fish at all times with this. I would say the least productive time would be in dirty water with a swim bait because it doesn't really make any noise. There's no rattles there. But aside from that, these baits are very, very effective. Now what happened is early on, you know, in the bass fishing world when swim baits started to kind of take over spinner baits and you would see the popularity of spinner baits slightly fading away. Well, what happened is early in the morning, you know, it'd be overcast and dark and we would throw spinner baits. But what would happen is the wind would lay down, the sun would come out, it would be a little higher pressure and slick calm. And that's where the swim bait came into play. So it used to be synonymous. The guys would throw the spinner bait when it got real windy and then they would switch to swim baits like this. But now, I mean, the popularity of swim baits like this are huge. Now, one of the really cool things Spooltech did here is you can clearly look at the package and see they included an extra tail. But what this is designed to do, this is a hard plastic right here. And the cool part is there's a stainless steel cable in here, which is wound up. Now, I'm gonna tell you something in regards to bass fishing. When a bass gets something in his mouth and there's some weight there, this lure is a half an ounce. If he comes up and shakes when they hit the surface, and I'm sure you've had it happen, they come up, whipping their head back and forth. They leverage the hook, they use the weight, and they're shaking the bait, which therefore creates a larger hole with that hook point, which creates leverage, and they throw that bait out. Now, Spooltech's address that. Watch this. Bump. Wow, check that out. That stainless steel cable slides out under just the right amount of pressure to keep that fish peg. Now, the benefit here is now he loses all the leverage of that weight in his mouth. So very, very cool feature and a very nicely designed bait. It's got a real big fat head. And the benefit of a fatter head like that is it can deflect off bottom structure and cover quite well. And you can also be dredged. And dredged just means casting it out, letting it fall to the bottom and bringing it right back across the bottom and bouncing along just like you're dredging something. So let's talk a little bit about retrieval. I've looked at this bait and I've dropped it in the water and it looks like it drops about 3 feet per second. Now, why is that beneficial for a swim bait like that? It's hugely beneficial because depending on time of day, depending on time of year, the fish are gonna fluctuate. Let's say it's summertime, the fish are gonna move down deeper or into heavier cover. I'm throwing an exposed hook here, so I clearly don't wanna throw this into heavier cover. So if I was fishing this in the summertime, I would be looking down deeper along ledges or big boulders, looking for the shade of the sun and fishing the opposite side. So in theory, you do this. If you think there's a boulder right here, and the sun's up over here, you wanna be casting to this side of the boulder because that's where the shade line's gonna be. And the cool part is, with a swim bait like this, falling at 3 feet per second, let's say it's 10 feet, so I know if I count to four, all right, I know if there's boulders out here, and I count 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4-1000, now I'm more than likely gonna be on the bottom. And I can slow roll that right along the bottom, get it in there behind those boulders and catch them. Now, if you're in the spring, those fish can be up in the pre-spawn, up shallow along the banks, and you can basically just cast out and reel right away right across the surface, and you're gonna still have that bait up in super shallow water. So a swim bait like this can be extremely versatile. Spring, fall, those fish are gonna be shallow, chasing what looks to be like a shad right here. This thing looks identical to a shad. A 4-inch shad's probably the most common bait fish across the whole entire country, to be perfectly honest with you. So a bait just like this here is gonna match that hatch flawlessly. And I'm looking at this hook right here. It looks like a six-aught hook right here. That's a black nickel. This is a very heavy, heavy duty hook. And it's a thicker diameter hook. So when it comes to the gear I'm gonna throw this on, I'm gonna throw it on a medium heavy bait casting rod. Now with a swim bait, you're casting it out there. You're making far casting, you're wanting to cover water. So a longer rod is gonna be critical. You know, if you're adamant about fishing a 6'6", go ahead, but I prefer 7, 7'6", 7'11". As long as I can get it is really what I want. And I don't like really a moderate fast, I like more of a fast. That means just bending up more to the tip. And the reason why, it's got a lot of backbone right here, which is gonna allow you to drive a heavier hook set on that fish. That being said, I wanna fish it on fluorocarbon line. I'm making a far cast. You don't have to fish it on fluorocarbon. This is merely my suggestion fluorocarbon is very low stretch, and you're gonna feel the rocks on the bottom. You're gonna feel when a fish hits it or swims up behind it. You're gonna be like, whoa, what happened there? And all of a sudden, he's gonna grab it at long range. Low stretch is gonna allow you to set that hook from long range. Now, reel speed, does that really matter? Not so much. You can fish it on pretty much any speed reel you want. But if you're like me and you're out there in the fall and you see bait moving around, sometimes I like to get it in fast. So I like to fish it on a 7-speed, not that critical. You could probably fish this bait down to 12-pound test, and I would say a 20-pound test. So that's your variation for there. So keep all that in mind. What I do like is I like a spool that can hold a lot of yardage. And the reason for that is I've said this in other videos, and this is something you don't have to do. This is merely a suggestion. I spool up a quarter of the way full on my spool with braided line. The reason for that is fluorocarbon's heavy, and I use a uni to uni knot, and I connect that fluorocarbon line on top. That means the weight is near the outside of my spool, so the centrifugal force is much faster, so I'm getting higher revolution speed of that line coming off my spool. It's a bigger loop, so I'm getting much more yardage on my cast, so I'm making very far casts with that. Do you need to do that to fish this? Absolutely not. But I like that long rod. I like a longer handle on my rod too. The reason for this, it's a big stout hook. I'm looking for a big, big bass. When she gets it, I like to leverage a hook set right in there behind my arm. So I like a longer handle, a medium heavy rod. Usually in a fast action, you can get away with an extra fast. You can get away with a moderate fast, just the way the rod bends, that's the taper. And that's pretty much your setup for you that you need to be throwing that bad boy on. So let's get into more. Now, when it comes to casting targets with a swim bait like this, I like steep bluff walls. I like grass lines. And you want to parallel stuff with a bait like this. Now, what I mean by parallel, take a look at this wall right here. Nice steep rock wall. Now, it also depends on time of year when those fish are going to be up shallow. In the fall, basically 58 degrees. To 58 degrees, you're gonna have fish that are shallow. Sometimes in the summertime, you will have those fish that move deep, but if there's shade lines up here, you will have those fish moving shallow. Now that being said, with your cast, I like to parallel that. Now I like to start off my cast and fish it relatively shallow. I wanna fish near the surface if I'm going to repeat cast. So let's say I have this bait hypothetically a foot under the surface right now. I cast it out there, I bring it in, I don't get bit. Now I'm gonna cast out, and you can see it's a steeper bluff wall. I'm gonna count to 3 or 4, and I'm fishing different parts of the water column. I'm fishing the top, the middle, and I may try to tractor it and bump it along the bottom on my third cast if I need to repeat cast, or if I was fishing from the bank, that's what I would do every single time. Another really awesome target, which I like in the pre-spawn, the post-spawn, and the fall, is standing timber. You look at this tree right here. This isn't standing timber, this is fallen timber, but you can still see that fish, that branch is sticking out relatively over 10 or 12 feet of water. Now, in the spring, what I like to do, I like to cast and I like to bring it right over the top near standing timber, right through the branches, through the uprights. A lot of the time, those bass are gonna sit in there, and when it comes right through those uprights, it's a perfect time to ambush. The reason for it is bass love vertical structure and vertical cover. You can get a tree out in the middle of a creek channel and they can drop straight up and down into 50 foot of water and be back within a couple feet of water instantaneous. So bringing a swim bait through the top of that standing timber can be phenomenal. So another perfect example, since the Spooltech swim bait looks like a shad, this is a school of bait right here, and this is a hard bottom. There's actually a couple fish right in the middle of the rocks along the hard bottom. And there's a fish that's actually right against the bottom right there, and he's following that shad. If you look, it's in between 10 and 15 feet. So I could cast out that Spooltech swim bait, let that thing fall, and count it down to right into that depth zone and bring it right through that shad. And then as soon as they see it trail out, these bass that are following, like here's another one following some bait along the bottom right here, will come up and capitalize on that one wounded shad. So don't think you always have to cast to a target. You see random bait on your graph, cast out, count it down, and take an opportunity at catching those unpressured fish. Oh, come on, come on, come on. Oh, there we go, there we go. And that's it for the Spooltech Fatty, guys. Nice little chunky one to end the evening. Appreciate you guys watching. Make sure to subscribe to Lucky Tackle Box on our YouTube channel here and check out all of our other social media on Instagram and Facebook as well. We'll see you next time.